Live from Dodger Stadium, Major League Baseball on tap. It's the Washington Nationals taking on the Los Angeles Dodgers. John Ciambi and Chris Singleton on the call. So the Los Angeles Dodgers are in position to sweep this three-game series with a win. So, Chris, what's their mindset heading into today?
Yeah, looking to go 3-for-3, Blue. They've already won the series, and now they can really leave their mark. It's all about having confidence, and that's what a team takes away from a sweep. So they're happy to win the series, but they'll really be riding high tomorrow with the win today.
First pitch coming your way next. Just about ready to go, and on the mound in this one, Clayton Kershaw. Singy always a treat when we get to watch him work.
Very crafty guy out there on the hill. A stellar career ERA in the low twos. Very tough to get to. Just when you think you've got him figured out, he flips the script. We'll see how the hitters are able to adapt to him today.
So just about set. And now up for Washington, Victor Robles. Base hit.
Now, no waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it on the first pitch. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Next to hit, Brady House. First pitch doesn't find the zone. And now 2-0. Runner at first with no outs here. Robles runs. Ball outside. The tag, and he's out at second.
Usually when you see a team try to steal a base in the early innings, it tells you they want to be aggressive on offense, try to force the defense to make plays and slow them down. That's exactly what they did right there. So we'll see if that caught stealing changes the offensive approach moving forward.
Kershaw fires. There's a strike. Nice warm day here. Good baseball weather. Does that change anything, Chris, especially for the hitters?
Absolutely. You feel so much more comfortable at the plate. You're not worried about, you know, getting jammed on fastballs inside part of the plate. You can kind of be more selective instead of just looking.
All right, let's take a look at the lineup. And so far this year, this has not been a very good offense.
Well, in this day and age, if you can't slug and get on base, that OPS has to be at a certain level. If you're going to produce runs, give your pitchers an opportunity as they're facing tough offenses as well.
Two outs, base is empty. And now it's Juan Soto.
All around, I think if you asked anyone in this organization who's the best hitter in the lineup, they would say him.
In there, and it's 0-1. No score, just getting started, top of the first. Next pitch is outside. One ball, one strike.
Well, Juan Soto had a huge 2021 season, just 1 point shy of 1,000 for OPS. Absolutely a monster at the plate. This guy's pretty special.
The 1-2. And a foul ball, he stays alive. I think the thing you start with for Soto is that patience and that strike zone understanding. A lifetime on base percentage well over 400. In the second half of 2021, he had an OBP over 500. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. And that's the third out. No score as we head to the bottom of the first. Back here in L.A. and at the plate for the Dodgers, Trey Turner.
Leading off for the Dodgers.
He burst onto the scene at 19 years old and looked several years older in terms of his maturity, his plate discipline, and how he handled pressure moments.
And that one pulled foul. The pitch. And that one off the outside edge. Next pitch misses. Now two balls and a strike. That one in for a strike, 2-2. And a pitch. Turner pops it up. And there's one away. Time to check out the Dodgers lineup. Here's the sixth spot for them in this one, Justin Turner.
Yeah, definitely someone I always enjoy, you know, when I get a chance to watch him, whether he's hitting in a game or even taking swings during batting practice. Man, this guy is always so focused on what he's doing on that task at hand. He's got so much attention to detail that when he steps in the box, his success rate is really high.
And now it's Mookie Betts. Betts having more success against left-handed pitching this season, as might be expected. He swings and fouls one off. Next offering is down low, and the count even 1-1. Right-hander kicks, deals. And a swing and a miss.
Well, that's that slurve right there. He threw it extremely well. You talk about just a ton of breaks. So tough to get that barrel to.
Next pitch, not close, up high. One down, base is empty. That's ripped, and this one could be extra bases. Around first and hustling for second. And he starts his afternoon off right with a double.
Well, his hot hitting continues. He's been getting great results lately. A well-deserved double on a great swing. Got everything going on time. He stayed balanced and squared it up about as well as you could possibly ask.
And at second with one away, Freddie Freeman up to the dish.
Batting third, the designated hitter, Freddie.
First offering, misses the
Freeman.
Mark. One and oh to Freddie Freeman.
2-0.
And there's the strike.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
Runner at second here, one gone. Pitch misses inside, 3-1 now.
Get ready for some action here. Good RBI guy at the plate, runners in scoring position, and a hitter's count.
And the right-hander's 3-1. And ball four to a board.
Pretty easy walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
Batting four. The first
well, they're really running up the pitch now. Count in this first inning. Lots of confidence from this team that is perhaps the hottest in baseball right now.
Max Muncy at the dish. Runners at first and second with one gone. Next offering is in for a strike.
I understand you want to try to gauge that guy's fastball, but you also have to be aggressive and ready to hit in your zone. Now you're in a tough spot.
The pitch. Got him. That's the second out.
Well, Boog, it becomes pretty difficult as a teammate when a guy's struggling like this. You don't know if you want to go up and tell him to keep swinging at, or if you want to give him his space, what exactly he needs. But right now, it's clearly a struggle for him, and we're just hoping that somehow, some way, it'll click, and he can get out of this as quickly as possible.
And up to the plate is Will Smith. And the first offering is not close. In there at the knees. And one and one.
One ball, one strike.
Two outs. A couple of base runners at first and second. Two outs. And that one almost got him.
Straightened him up a little bit.
Two on, two outs. And now the count filled up 3-2. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
Here comes the runner.
In there safely.
Always feels good when you come through and get your team on the board first. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch, just shot it through the infield.
So two on with two away. Turner climbs in on that right side.
The third baseman.
First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Turner. It's great to get on the board in the first frame of the ball game, but here's an opportunity for them to really open things up with a couple of runners on. Let's see if they can cash in.
Kicks and deals. Fouled off left side. First and second, two down. Next one misses. 1-2 to count. And now it's even up. At the belt and final. Liner, base hit. Runner around third. Check that. He'll stop at first with a single after putting on the brakes. The run comes in from second. It's 2-0.
Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the ball straight to it. That's great work right there.
Here's Cody Bellinger.
Batting seven, the center fielder.
In there for strike one.
Well, with this many pitches thrown here in this first inning, I mean, you're giving the other team a really good look. He's going to have to find a way to get some weak contact, maybe a swing and miss, get into that dugout and hit the reset button.
And here it comes. Oh, right to the backstop. Left-hand batter waits. Falling behind 2-1.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge pitch coming.
And the right-hander deals. And downstairs.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
Next offering finds the zone, and the count is full. Next offering is fouled back. That one ripped. Brings it in for the third out. On to the second now from Dodger Stadium. It's the Dodgers 2 and the Nationals nothing. Josh Bell at the plate now. His split numbers between June and July there.
The first baseman, number 19, Josh Bell.
The wind to kick the pitch. And he dodges that fastball.
Well, you've got to establish the inside part of the plate early, and that sends a message not just to this hitter, but to the rest of the guys in this lineup.
Next pitch inside, ball two.
When you get ahead in the count, there's no doubt that the success rate goes up, and that's what he's been doing. It's made a big impact for him in recent games.
The 2-0 is in for a strike. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. A little slider action.
And now the lefty stays alive. Two two now. And a foul ball, he stays alive. And he deals. Off the plate inside, and it's 3-2. The wind of the pitch. Ripped on a line. This looks like extra bases. Now he'll turn for second. And he's got a leadoff double.
Drove that ball nicely, put a great swing on it, and it jumped off his bat. Kind of put it all together there, and he's rewarded with the double.
Here's Lane Thomas.
And Boog, I'd say he's due.
Shoots a line drive single into right center. Stop sign goes up at third. Runners at the corners. Nobody out.
Batting sixth, the catcher, Keibert.
And now it's Keibert Ruiz. A switch hitter batting right. And it's fouled away. Two on, nobody out. Kershaw deals.
Well, the offense really struggled last night. I mean, it was awful. So I think picking up a run right here, that's going to get him going a little bit.
Runners on the corners, no outs. Kershaw checks on the runner, and he's back safely. Lefty out of the stretch, runners at first and third. He was looking to come up with the shutdown inning and off to a shaky start. Kicks and fires. Foul ball there. The pitch. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. One away.
Well, pitchers have become so much better at commanding that high fastball. It used to be that a lot of guys didn't like to throw it because it threw off their release point and their mechanics, and they're aimed at keeping everything at the knees, get ground balls. But because hitters get a swing path that can lift balls at the knees up in the air and over the fence, this pitch has come back into play, and they are doing some special things with it.
And that one wrapped foul. Runners are at the corners, one away. Next offering is fouled back. Next one just misses, and the count is 1-2.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. I really think the outer half is open.
Next offering is down low.
That's a really good take.
And the pitch stays alive. The pitch.
So here we go. Base runner at first, could be running on the pitch. He's got good enough speed to steal the bag to get in scoring position, even if it's a swing and miss at the plate.
Two on, one out, and that'll load the bases.
Now that sets up a really big at bat in this game. These are the moments when everyone in the stadium gets really locked in.
Mikel Franco getting ready to hit. And the first pitch misses for ball one. So the tying run at second. Hit on the ground might be two. Over to Taylor. And that's two.
Just trying to sneak one through with the bases loaded, but an excellent job by the defense to turn that one and get out of this jam.
Back here at Dodger Stadium, Chris Taylor now.
He's got pop, which is a little sneaky because he's so comfortable with taking his base hits to the opposite field, but he can jump you if you make a mistake.
First pitch just misses.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
Saying he wasn't very sharp in the first, got hit around a little bit, just wasn't able to locate particularly well. A lot of stuff for the fat part of the plate.
Yeah, Boog, he wasn't fooling anyone. It's a tough place to be because it's not always obvious what adjustments need to be made. Sometimes it's location. Sometimes it's being too predictable. Sometimes you're tipping your pitches. He's going to need to figure it out quickly, though.
Line drive, base hit. Now he turns and heads for second. They're still chasing it as he rounds second. And he makes it into third with a leadoff triple. And now it's Gavin Lux.
Batting ninth, the left fielder, Gavin.
In the air out to center, Robles coming in on it. One down.
The batter number six. Shortstop.
Now it's the shortstop, Trey Turner. He's 0 for 1. First pitch, not close. Runner on at third, one gone. Next offering misses, and now 2-0.
This is a situation where the hitter is looking for something up in the zone that he can get his arms extended. What you have to be careful of is that pitch that's up, that's in on your hands. That'll pop you up in the infield, and that's exactly what the pitcher wants.
2-0. That one misses. Ball three. Appears they're working around him with the base open, Singy.
Well, you know, these 2-0 counts, Boo, they're just not what they used to be, and we sound like old guys when I say that, but ultimately, this is a strategic game, and you expect to see this type of approach by the pitcher in this situation.
So Turner reaches base, and this is a guy with good speed.
Definitely lost the handle during that sequence. Four pitches for the walk, and that last one didn't even threaten the zone. Catcher might want to go talk to him.
On the ground, could be two. Off balance feed, there's one. Double play, and that'll do it for the inning. We played two full. It's the Dodgers 2 and the Nationals nothing. Back here at Chavez Ravine, all set for the start of the inning. And the batter now, Cesar Hernandez.
The second baseman, Cesar Hernandez.
The wind of the pitch. Got it started a little too early. Strike one. Swings and misses. No balls, two strikes. Oh and two now. That one misses. It's a ball and two strikes. Hard on the ground to first. Muncy takes it to the bag. Leadoff hitter gone in the third.
The center field, number 16, Victor Robles.
So the next lineup turns over. Victor Robles, the next to hit. And first offering is fouled off. Next pitch is in the dirt, and it's 1-1. Drops one down in front of the plate. And he grabs it in foul ground. The pitch. Way inside, and that hit him. He had two strikes on him, and he hit him.
Well, in the box, he's seen that movie before. It wasn't a good movie either. He knew how it was going to end right from the beginning.
The next to hit takes outside.
Nasty backdoor slider. There's really nothing you can do with that if you swing at it. So that's a good take by him.
The lefty, the 1-0. Slider misses outside.
Last couple of pitches, breaking balls away. I think he's going to have to come firm inside to be able to open up that location if he wants to go back there later in this count.
Foul ball. Robles runs. There's a ball. Save!
When your catcher's not a great thrower, you have to do a better job at controlling the running game. And that's throwing over, that's stepping off, doing whatever you can to try to keep that base stealer's rhythm off. Well, they weren't able to do it right there. They're going to have to make some type of adjustment, or guys are going to be running all game.
The 3-1. And the tying run is on base.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base up with a quick free pass. The
right Juan fielder. Soto now. One. So RBI spot, but Chris, this is a guy that is not really swinging the bat all that well here.
In this situation, you have a real good opportunity to get swings and misses and record a strikeout. I think you attack him in this spot.
That one's in there, 0-1.
If you're going to be a championship type of ball club, you've got to hit with runners in scoring position. And after last night's struggles, I'm sure these guys are chomping at the bit to have this kind of opportunity here early in this game.
Left-hand hitter waits. That one missed.
No base hits in the series for him so far, and it's clearly been a rough one. You just hope he's not pressing too hard, because that just compounds things. It makes the slump even longer. Never seems to help. Never helped me.
Next offering is foul back. One out. Runners at first and second. Next pitch is downstairs. Two now to 22, and a foul ball. He stays alive. Here's the 2-2. Right side, hard hit, and it goes just foul. Two now. Hard hit left side. That's a base hit. Robles around third. He'll score. It's 2-1. A perfect example right there. That plate discipline, it pays off.
The deeper he gets into a count, the more comfortable he becomes, and he usually wins the battle.
2-on, 1-out. Here's Josh Bell. Next pitch downstairs, and it's 1-0. Next offering is in for a strike.
That fastball, even though it's up, that's the velocity you want to go after. Low 90s, a lot better than trying to hit the high 90s.
And a pitch. And now two balls and a strike.
Looks like he's being a little cautious with him in this at bat after doubling the first time up. Doesn't want to make another mistake.
Next offering is downstairs. And the 3-1. Pitches in for a strike. 3 balls, 2 strikes. And now the lefty. That one down the line. And foul ball.
That fastball at the bottom of the zone can be very effective. Just got to keep it on the corners.
Yeah. Next offering is fouled back. And a payoff pitch. And that's ball four.
Well, he's normally going to fill up the strike zone and really limit base runners, but his command in this one just seems off out there. A lot more walks than he's used to giving up.
Thomas at the plate now, and that's inside.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Next offering is in for a strike.
It's amazing to look up and see 88 miles per hour on that changeup. Back in the day, that was a pretty good fastball. But with high velocities these days, that speed differential is right where it needs to be.
Swing and a miss. Huge strikeout there.
Well, this is where the team aspect really comes into play on the offensive side of the game, right? I mean, missed opportunity to tie it up with the runner at third, one out, couldn't put the ball in play. So now it's time to pick him up. And that's where good teams, they go to. They operate on this level of next man up. That mentality is what causes them to win series, get into the postseason. That helps keep the energy and morale high in the dugout.
Next to hit, Hebert Ruiz. First pitch doesn't find the zone. At the belt and fires. There's a strike.
Well, they kept him pretty quiet in this series. Still doesn't have a knock. I know. You want to get that first knock out of the way. Maybe more will come, but you got to give some credit to the pitching staff. They've had a great plan against him.
The lefty ready, and a 1-1. And strike two.
He has a tendency to chase out of the zone, and that slider that's down, that's one of his money pitches to get that swing and miss.
Here's a 1-2. Three. And down on strikes he goes. That's out number three, but the RBI single pushes across a run, and it's now a 2-1 ball game. As we go to the last of the third, here comes Freddie Freeman up to hit.
Love how vocal the umpire is today. No doubt in the hitter's mind, catcher's mind, and even the pitcher's mind as to the conviction in the call.
The right-hander back to work. That misses, and that's ball one. Next pitch is outside.
And that's a pitch early in this game. He needs called for a strike. Struggling with command issues. He's got to get a little help from the umpire.
The wind to kick the 2-0. That's off the mark, and that's ball three. Let's see if he gives him anything to hit here. Edge of the zone, called a strike. And the count is 3-1. The 3-1. Fouled off to the right. And a pitch. Downstairs, and it misses ball four.
Leading off.
Here's Max Muncy, that funky Muncy. He was a strikeout victim his first time.
Muncy.
First pitch, and he just misses.
Count 1-0.
Next offering is in for a strike. The pitch. Fastball, and he gets out of the way. And the pitch. Good eye right there. Nobody out. Runner at first. And a foul ball. Righty delivers. And a foul ball. Next offering is fouled back.
Pitcher having a pretty tough time getting that swing and miss. Third foul ball in a row.
Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Ninth pitch of the at-bat due next. Muncy hits one in the air. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down.
Now batting. The catcher.
Will Smith.
The batter now will be Will Smith. First offering misses the mark. Right-hander kicks, deals. That's inside.
Last two pitches have been down in the zone. Pitcher clearly trying to get that ground ball double play. But in this count, you're going to have to give in, elevate his pitches, and get back into this at-bat.
That to right. And they get the out on Smith. Out number two.
Now batting, third baseman, Justin Turner.
Justin Turner steps to the plate for the Dodgers. If he's already singled in this game. And that's in there for strike one.
Well, don't expect too many more high fastballs. This is a good sinker ball pitcher, and sometimes they can make mistakes trying to pitch up in the zone. Look for him to stay down around the knees to be effective.
Fouled off. He was late. Next pitch in the dirt, and it's 1-2. Line drive, base hit.
Now batting, the center fielder, Cody.
First and second, two
Bellinger.
Down. And up next for Los Angeles, Cody Bellinger. And fouled off. And the righty deals.
One ball, one strike.
And another ball.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
The 2-1. And And that one in the air center field. Robles makes the catch, and that'll do it. Dodgers strand a couple, but they still lead it 2-1. And welcome back as we go to the top of the fourth. Up now for Washington, John Kenzie Noel.
Third baseman, number 78.
Kershaw back to work. That one off the mark, and that is ball one. Next offering is in for a strike.
Back-to-back fastballs in. That last one called for a strike. Probably go away, but look for him to come back in there to try to finish you off.
And now the count 1-2 after the swing and the miss. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. And now 2-2.
I got to count 2-2.
Here's a 2-2. On the ground to short, Turner picks it up. Fires across the diamond. That's the first out in the top of the fourth.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Next to hit for the Nats, Michael Franco. In there, and it's 0-1. To the right side, Taylor collects it, gathers, and throws to first. Two quick outs here in the top of the fourth.
The batter number one, second baseman, Cesar Hernandez.
Cesar Hernandez up to the plate. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
The next offering misses, and that's ball one. On a line out towards center. Bellinger makes the catch, and that'll do it. Nationals go quietly. And they trail it here 2-1. Back here at the ballpark, John Chabi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Chris Taylor.
The second baseman, Chris Taylor.
And here it comes. That one drilled left field. Holy Toledo! Chris Taylor blasts one out. It's his sixth home run of the season. It's 3-1.
Well, he went up there 0-0 looking to do damage. I think he had his sights set on that pitch. He went and got it and circled the bases.
And next for L.A., Gavin Lux.
The left fielder, number 9.
Gavin. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
Check swing on a 1-0. Appeal to third. Yes, he did. That's a swing. bounced up the middle. On to first, and that's the first out. Nice recovery after giving up the homer.
The batter number six, shortstop.
Trey Turner now. He's turned into one of the best shortstops in the game. First pitch, just misses.
Count 1-0.
And that's downstairs and outside. On the ground at first, and he takes it himself for the out.
The batter, the right fielder, Mookie.
Here's Mookie to hit. First offering misses badly for ball one. Comes a pitch. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. And a swing and a miss, and that's that. Dodgers add one to their lead on the solo homer. It's now a 3-1 ball game. Welcome back. And now the center fielder, Victor Robles.
Leading off for Washington, the center fielder, number 16, Victor Robles.
Hawaii to kick the pitch. That misses the zone. 1-0. Next offering is down low. Swing and a miss. 2-1 now.
As a hitter, you got to learn something from that pitch. You clearly wasn't timed up on the fastball. In a 2-0 count, you have to be ready to do damage.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And the leadoff hitter retired in the fifth.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
Number nine.
And now up for Washington, Brady House. 2-for-9 so far in the series. Swings and sends a rocket to right. Betts makes the play, 2 down.
Now batting. Right fielder, Juan Soto.
2 outs, base is empty. Now the youngster, Juan Soto, 1-for-2. And he grounds one back up the middle. Oh, great stop. And it beats him. What a play.
This guy's anticipation is off the charts. Don't see many shortstops better than that. Great job to complete the play and end the inning.
Back now to start the bottom of the fifth and taking over on the mound, Aaron Sanchez.
Number 21.
This is his third time out this year.
Well, at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and we need a little length out of this arm. Coming out of the bullpen, we'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Back here in L.A., and now it's going to be Freddie Freeman.
Freddie Freeman.
The wind of the pitch. That one finds the corner. Strike one. Double-barreled action in the bullpen. Kyle Finnegan appears to be getting loose. Cishek getting loose as well. Next pitch misses, and it's a ball and a strike. And that one sliced foul. The other way, and he beats the shift.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feel. Smash that one through the infield for the knock. When it's hit that hard, it makes it very tough on the infielders to make any sort of play.
And now it's Max Muncy. Next offering is down low, and it's 1-0. The 1-0. And that's outside. Here's a 3-0. And he walked him.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, boo.
And now, Will Smith, 1-for-2. He had an RBI base hit back to the first. In there for strike one.
Not the easiest thing when you're talking about a guy that's, you know, perhaps is going to be in the rotation. You know, maybe a long relief guy to not start an inning, to come into an inning with pressure on it and try to get yourself comfortable.
Next pitch misses outside, and now it's even 1-1. The 1-1. And that one fouled off. Righty to the plate. This one chopped on the ground, but foul. The pitch. First and second here, no outs. Smash to the left side, and that's just foul. Two two now. Hard hit, right side, and there's a hit. There comes the runner. He scores, and they're up by 3.
That's back-to-back singles for him. Pitch was away, and he did exactly what you're supposed to do with it. Drive it the other way. Just go with the pitch.
Now Justin Turner gets a chance to hit.
Now batting, the third baseman, Justin.
That one's in there, 0-1.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has a very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit.
And the pitch. That one fouled off. No outs, runners at first and second. Hard hit, left field, base hit. They won't test it here. Base is loaded, no outs.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one.
Nice line drive to the full side. Met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
Now the base is loaded. Big opportunity for them to break this game open.
And up to the plate comes Cody Bellinger. And that's in there for strike one. Bases loaded, nobody out. In the air, right field. Soto ranging back. He makes the grab. Both runners tagging from second and third. He's in to score on the sac fly, and they lead by four. And at the plate for the Dodgers, Chris Taylor. Left field. Thomas puts the squeeze on that one. Runner tags for home. He's in on the sacrifice fly. It's 6-1.
No, that's the third run of the inning, and these guys are doing a nice job of executing at the plate right now.
Now on the mound for the Nationals, Austin Voth. He comes on for the 35th time this year.
Number 50, Austin Voth.
Gavin Lux steps to the plate for the Dodgers. In there, and it's 0-1. And the 0-1 misses outside. Ball one. And now 2-1. Right-handed reliever. He swings and fouls one off. Out to short, dives, and he can't hang on. And he beats it. He's safe. Safe at first as they can't make the play.
The batter number six. Good stop.
So the batting order turns over. Trey Turner at the plate. And the first offering is not close. And the 1-0. And that one fouled off. And the next pitch is way outside. One now. In the air, out towards right center. Robles on the move. Makes the catch in and over. Five innings complete. It's the Dodgers 6 and the Nats 1. Back here at Dodger Stadium, all set for the top of the sixth. Now it's the Nationals' cleanup hitter, Josh Bell.
The first baseman, number 19, Josh Bell.
A wind in the pitch. And delivers outside. The Dodgers bullpen with some action. Phil Bickford getting loose out there. Grotterol warming up as well. Next offering is in for a strike. That one close, ruled a ball, and it's 2-1. Fouls one off, 2-2. The pitch. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Man at first, and now Lane Thomas. First pitch, not close.
Maybe losing command a little bit after the walk. Next pitch, not even close.
The lefty, the 1-0. And there's a ball. There's a strike.
Good approach right there. You want to get something just a little higher that you can elevate. Stay out of that double play.
Kershaw, the 2-1. In the air, fairly deep to right field. Betts pulls that one down, and there's one down.
Now batter, the catcher, Hebert.
Here's the catcher to hit, Hebert Ruiz. Ground ball left side, could be two. Over to second for one. On to first, double play, and that's the inning. 2-3-4, two up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Dodgers six, and the Nats one. And welcome back. Now it's Mookie Betts.
Leading up for the Dodgers, the right fielder, Mookie Betts.
Both back to work. And first offering is fouled off.
Looked like you got a little excited on that fastball. Got to think to yourself, I want to stay up the middle. That way, if you're a little bit early, you hit it out of the ballpark. If you're a little late, opposite field knock.
Right side. And there's one down.
Up next for the Dodgers, the designated hitter, Freddie.
So now here's the DH, Freddie Freeman. And first offering is fouled off. Next pitch is inside, 1-1. And the right-hander deals. Smoked on the ground a second. Hernandez over to first in time. And Freeman is retired.
Now batting, the first baseman, Matt Muncy.
Two outs, base is empty. Max Muncy steps to the plate for the Dodgers.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely, try to hit the ball out of the park, do what he loves to do.
Next pitch downstairs, and that's ball one. Next one off the plate inside. Now 2-0. The 2-0 is in for a strike. Next pitch is downstairs. Two outs. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Oh, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. Smith stands in now, looks at that one inside. The pitch. And there's a foul ball. This one high in the air to left center. Can't get there. Base hit. Lead runner gets the stop sign at third. It's a two-out double, second and third now.
Having himself a really nice game at the plate. Pretty much just a textbook double into the gap. And when you can drop one in there between the outfielders, you know you're making the turn at first. Just an excellent swing.
Here's Turner now. Batting 4-for-6 in the series.
Justin Turner.
And first offering is fouled off. That hits the dirt. One ball, one strike. Here's a 1-1. Base hit. One run in already. Now two runs score. And they're pulling away up by 7 now.
Back-to-back base hits. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Bellinger up to hit.
The center fielder, number 35, Cody.
First pitch, and he just misses. Left-hand batter waits. Fought off foul. Next pitch off the plate. 2-1.
When the skipper calls down to the bullpen, he's expecting the guy to come in and get outs. So far, not getting what he was hoping for.
That one is hammered right field. That's back there. Holy Toledo. Cody Bellinger blasts one out, and they add a pair. It's 10-1. Cause I'm
That one was a hanger, and pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
Steve Cishek on the pitch here. He's being eased into the game here with the bases empty. Two outs, nobody on. Chris Taylor now at the plate.
The batter, number three, second baseman, Chris Taylor.
Now a screamer into the outfield. And that will end the inning. Seventh inning coming up. It's the Dodgers 10 and the Nats 1. Back here at Chavez Ravine, here's the third baseman, John Kenzie Noel.
The third baseman, number 78.
The wind of the pitch. And a foul ball.
Pretty impressive. We haven't seen that pitch from him much, but he's got a really good feel when he throws it.
Kicks and fires. And a foul ball. The next pitch misses, and a count 1-2.
Pretty standard high 0-2 fastball right there. If you're smart, you'll look for something down in the zone, but not too far. Don't want to chase that breaking ball in the dirt.
That missed inside, 2-2. And he deals. Tap to first. Muncy collects. Muncy steps on the bag, and they get the leadoff hitter in the seventh.
Good late life on that inside fastball. Ran in on the hands and got that weak contact. Little slow grounder to get the out.
Now here is Michael Franco. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. Two away.
The batter number one, second baseman, Cesar Hernandez.
And here is Cesar Hernandez. In there for strike one.
Well, as good as things can be, it can be a tough day at the office, even for the skippers. Seeing the offense just sputter, not able to get anything going.
Way inside, gets out of the way. The 1-1. Foul ball there. Next pitch is outside.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
And he swings and lifts one to deep center field. That's back there. Didn't quite have enough. Three up, three down for Washington. They're down 9. It's 10-1. Back here at the ballpark, set for the last half of the seventh. And at the plate for the Dodgers, Gavin Lux.
The left fielder, Gavin Lux.
And a pitch. And that one just misses. A ball and no strikes. The Nationals have some action going in the pen. Kyle Finnegan, the hard-throwing righty, is up and loosening. Smith getting cranked up as well. Next offering is in for a strike. Ball to strike. Not the best swing that time from the first round pick. And a pitch. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. One away.
Good pitch right there. I mean, he's attacking a location that this guy at the plate tends to have trouble with. And there's just so much information in this day and age. Sometimes too much information, but the guys that can take that information, process it, and then go out there, Boog, and execute the pitch, go right after that hitter, and get the result that they were anticipating. That's really good pitching right there. And it's a good job of the pitcher and the catcher working together.
Here's Trey Turner. Foul ball. That misses, and the count even, 1-1. Kicks and deals. Swing and a pop-up. Noel under it. And there are two down.
Now batting. The right fielder, Mookie Betts.
Here's Mookie Betts. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
This batter has to understand his job is to get on base however he can. If he gets hit by a pitch, if he walks, maybe even singles. But you want to get the heart of the order up to the plate.
The 1-0. Hit high in the air. There it goes. See ya. Mookie Betts blasts one out. Home run number 20 on the year, and they add on. It's 11-1. Singing, he's been red hot.
Yeah, another big swing of the bat for him. Man, he is really seeing the ball well in this one. With a low 90s fastball, you have to live on the edges and hit your spots. If you don't, you'll get hit hard. Really good swing there. Patient, waited for it. It was like BP all over again. So you wanna be a rambling
man. And now here's the Dodgers designated hitter, Freddie Freeman.
Designated hitter, number five, Freddie.
Pitch misses inside, ball one. At the belt and fires. And he pumps it a strike. And misses inside. Two and one now. Bounce to the right side. There's Hernandez handling the chance. Sends it to first, and Freeman is retired. Inning over. Mookie Betts with a big strike in the inning. Eighth inning coming up. Major League Baseball is on the show. New pitcher for the Dodgers, Phil Bickford. And he's got a nice lead to work with.
Number 52, Phil Bickford.
Ready to begin the eighth. Here's the center fielder, Victor Robles.
The center fielder, Victor Robles.
the pitch. That one is upstairs. Activity in the bullpen for the Dodgers. Brewstar Grotterol looks to be getting ready for manager Dave Roberts. Price getting loose as well. And the righty deals. Popped up. And out number one on the grab.
Now batting number nine.
Brady House digging in for the Nationals. First offering, and it just misses.
Ball one, no strike.
Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field. Lux racing over to make the catch.
Now batting, the right fielder, Juan Soto.
Digging in, Juan Soto, one for three. First offering misses the mark. Two down, nobody on. In the air on the infield. Muncy giving chase. Puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. This one pretty well decided at this point. Home half of inning number eight straight ahead. It's the Dodgers 11 and the Nats 1. Welcome back. Here's some real power at the plate. Max Muncy.
For the Dodgers, the first baseman, Max Muncy.
The pitch. And first offering is fouled off. Righty delivers. Strike two. That one misses. One and two to count. And a pitch. And that one moves his feet. Here comes a pitch. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. And that's the first out. Next up, the Dodgers catcher, Will Smith. That one's in there, 0-1.
All ones that count.
The 0-1. And that's outside. Righty to the plate. Check swing, but he went too far. It's 2-2. The 2-2.
Thank you.
Slapped foul. Payoff pitch. Swing and a ball lifted in the air left field. Pretty well struck. Way back there. Holy Toledo! His 23rd of the year, and they tack on to their lead. It's 12-1.
Booth, clearly some frustration out there on the mound right now. I mean, that ball was so close to going foul. Would have been a long strike, but instead, batter gets rewarded. Did a nice job of getting to the pitch and hitting it hard enough to get over the fence.
New arm out of the bullpen, Kyle Finnegan. Hey, this guy can bring it velocity-wise. Here's Justin Turner.
Now batting, third baseman, Justin.
First pitch, just misses. A ball and no strikes to the Nationals' third baseman. Up the middle, and Turner is retired.
The center fielder, number 35, Cody Bellinger.
And now the center fielder, Cody Bellinger. First offering misses badly for ball one. And the 1-0. Swing and a miss. Strike one. And a 1-1. And that one fouled off. In the air, center field. Thomas flying after this one. Hops over the wall, and that's an automatic double.
The automatic double kind of feels like enjoying cruise control in your car, Boog. You don't need to keep the pedal down as you cruise into second base. Just no worries in the world. You know what? He put a really good swing on that one.
Here's the second baseman, Chris Taylor.
Number three, second baseman, Chris Taylor.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. Two outs and one in scoring position. Right-hander kicks, deals. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. The pitch. That one to first. Boots it. But in time, nice job to stay with it to end the inning. Solo shot for the Dodgers this inning. Last chance coming up here for the Nationals. New inning getting started. Up now for Washington, Josh Bell.
Leading off for Washington, the first baseman, number 19, Josh Bell.
Bickford back to work. And that one wrapped foul. And the right-hander deals. Strike two. The pitch stays alive. Left-hand batter waits. On the ground to third. Slides, but he can't come up with it.
Well, that certainly feels good when you can win the at-bat after being down in the count, up against it with two strikes right there. Great approach on a nice pitch, dropped the barrel on it, stayed on plane completely through the swing, and drove it the other way. Kind of have to tip your cap if you're on the mound on that one.
And the batter now, Lane Thomas. And the first offering is not close.
Well, the leadoff man gets on. You want to minimize the threat by playing sound defense. Hopefully the pitcher can get a ball on the ground and they can roll him up for two.
Next one misses and the count is 2-0. And fouled off. Next pitch misses, 3-1. Three-one is on the way. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
His ability to draw walks has been something that's been part of his career since day one.
And now the switch hitting catcher, Hebert Ruiz. And that's in there for strike one. And now the 0-1. Swing and a miss. 0-2 now. And here it comes. And now 1-2.
Just not taking the bait right there, but a good pitch with two strikes.
Kicks and fires. That one missed. And a swing and a miss, one out.
Typically that high fastball, if it's close to the top of the strike zone, a hitter, if he's prepared for it, can get to it. But that one just had that little jump at the end, which indicates there's a good spin rate on it, and it didn't decrease in velocity as that hitter's internal clock would expect it to, and that's why you see the swing and miss.
Now, Jonkenzie Noel in there, and it's 0-1. And a pitch. He swings and fouls one off. In the air, right field. That'll drop in. Plays it on a hop. And they hold the runner at third, but the bases are loaded now with one out.
Up next for Washington.
With the way defenders track down balls these days, I mean, both from the infield and in the outfield, there really aren't a lot of base hits on balls hit like that. But there's always a little room back behind the first and second baseman to drop a lawn dart in there, and he found a way.
Now here is Michael Franco. And a pitch. Swing and a miss.
Got the count. Oh, and two.
The pitch. And down on strikes. Now only one out remaining.
Gosh, here it is. Hit it. Three pitch strikeout. All fastballs. Man, he's got a lot of confidence in that pitch right now.
Hernandez.
Cesar Hernandez digs in now as the Nationals are down to their final out. Pitch misses inside, and that is ball one. This one in the air, right field. Betts settles under it. He'll squeeze it for the final out, and the Dodgers slug their way to a win in this one.
Nice sweep in this series, and you continue playing at home. Everything feels good right now. This is the type of run that you can put together a nice, long winning streak. We'll see if they're able to do it in the next game.
12-1 is the final. Dave Roberts and company celebrate in the dugout. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shambi. We'll see you soon. Yeah, you want the cheese, but without no jeans, you ain't conceived. Sleep on the couch, shooting the scene, and making the scene. It's two different things, you're not about A-OK, A-OK. Yeah. I feel like I got a lot to prove. I feel like y'all cannot walk in my shoes. I feel like I'm damaged beyond repair. I feel like I lost a whole lot of screws. I feel like as a kid, I
got time at the ballgame, 3 hours and 41 minutes. Our paid attendance this afternoon. A sellout, 56,000. The Dodgers thank you for attending today's game. And as you leave Dodger Stadium, we remind you to please drive home safely.